I'm going to do a daredevil experiment with you, and that is called Ice Skater's Delight. You will see that it is not a delight at all, but in any case, it is definitely a fun experiment. I have here a turntable, very little friction, and I'm going to rotate the turntable about the center, and I'm going to stand on that turntable, and I will hold in my hand two weights, these two. They're each about 1.8 kilograms. So these weights, M, 1.8 kilograms. My entire mass, including the turntable and my body, let's say, is about 75 kilograms. And I'm going to ask someone to give me a little twist to rotate me about this axis of symmetry. Rotate me, say, if you look from below, let's say I'm being rotated clockwise. So we have here a situation of a rotation about the center of mass, so we can talk about the intrinsic angular momentum of this rotating system. And the angular momentum vector will obviously be pointing upwards. That's clear. If you rotate clockwise from below, remember here you were rotating counterclockwise, it was coming out of the blackboard. Here you rotate clockwise, it will be going up. So far, so good. There is a force on me due to gravity, mg, no concern. There is an equally strong force, normal force up, and the two cancel each other out. Once I have been given a certain rotation, a certain angular velocity, I'm going to pull my arms in and pull my arms out and pull my arms in. And when I do that, that does not cause a net torque on this system. I can keep doing that all the time, and there is no net torque. And so angular momentum, as we have specified for a spinning object, must be conserved, cannot change. L equals I omega. But as I pull my arms in, my moment of inertia will go down. And if my moment of inertia goes down, then if this product has to remain constant, my angular velocity must go up, and vice versa. So when I pull my arms in, I will go faster, and when I do this, I will go slower. And I want to be a little bit quantitative with you. I simplify my own body by a geometric object for which I can calculate the moment of inertia, which is a cylinder. I may not look like a cylinder, but close enough for all practical purposes. And this cylinder has a radius of about 20 centimeters. Not too bad. Sort of fits me. And I'm going to rotate this cylinder around this axis, and I can calculate now what the moment of inertia is. This cylinder has a mass of 75 kilograms, has a radius of 20 centimeters, and so the moment of inertia in the situation that, for instance, I have these two objects next to my body here, or I have them like here, so this is my shorthand notation, equals simple 1/2 m r squared. Remember, that was the moment of inertia we discussed that last time of a rotating disk which rotates about the line of symmetry. And so if I put in the numbers here, the 75 kilograms, and I take a radius of 20 centimeters, then I found that this is about 1.5 in our MKS units. But now I'm going to put my arms like this. And now the moment of inertia will go up. And I'll make a very crude calculation how much it goes up. My arm length is about 90 centimeters. The weights here are 1.8 kilogram. So I just assume that my arms have no weight, for simplicity, that all the weight is in these two objects. It's a simplification, but you'll see there's a dramatic change, and that's all I want you to see. So now the moment of inertia, when my arms are like this, of course, is my body, which is the 1.5, that is still there, but now there is an additional component, one from this mass, which is mr squared, and one from this mass, which is mr squared, where this is now that radius r. And so I get twice that mass, and then I have to take r squared, which is 0.9 squared, and I have to take the 1.8. Because that's the moment of inertia of this object about this point. That is m r squared. I assume that my arm has no mass. And when you add this up, you'll find 4.5 in MKS units, kilograms, meters squared. And now you see, if I go from this situation to this, my moment of inertia goes down by a factor of 3. And if my moment of inertia goes down by a factor of 3, my angular velocity must go up by a factor of 3, and vice versa. I want to do this experiment, but this experiment is not without danger. The problem with this experiment is that the moment that you pull your arms in, you get immediately extremely dizzy, and you can lose your balance, and you can fall flat out on the floor. And I've just talked this morning with some students here who did that in high school, and he told me that indeed one of the teachers went flat down, and I try not to do that today. So I need really assistance from someone whom I can trust. You think I can trust you? Not you. That's an honest answer. You are a strong man. You can I trust you? The first thing I want you to do is to help me get on here, because even getting on here is not easy. If I just step on here, I will probably fall. Okay, so stand there, put your arm around my neck, support me strongly. Yeah? Okay. All right, there we go. Now stay with me for a while. Okay, just stay there. All right. Now you give me a reasonable angular velocity, whatever you think is reasonable. I'll tell you if it's completely unreasonable. Give me a push. That's fine. Wow, is it fine? Now you walk a little bit away. If I fall, try to catch me. Okay, my arms go in now. My arms go out. My arms go in. My arms go out. Okay, now I'm completely dizzy now. This is no joke. So stop me. Yeah? Just hold it. No, just hold me. Hold me. Okay, give my hand. Okay. Okay, you passed the course. Sacrifice for the sake of science. Oh, all right, I've done worse.